arrive to Panama, that go through customs. Alright, about to exit.
You work all weekend?
The weekend? No, I'm not working on weekend. I'm going to check a place. It's like 5 hours from Panama.
You have to be over 18. That's it.
Perfect.
18. To eat, to drink, to do anything.
Really?
Shit. Damn.
Checking into Panama. One of my friends from Panama picked us up in the airport. We're currently staying at his family's house. We got a little bunk bed hanging out here. We got here around 2 a.m. so it's pretty late right now. Tomorrow we have a lot of things planned. We're gonna go out, do some sightseeing. We're probably gonna go to Ancon Hill to check out the highest point in Panama. I'm excited. This is my first trip for my blog, and I hope that you guys enjoy what I show you. Got my man Carlos on the trip with me. Show some support.
Of course. We out here exploring. Adventure time, baby.
What you think about Panama so far?
I love it.
You love it?
I like it.
Man, we just got here, man.
I like what I saw.
We just got dropped off at the bottom of Ancon Hill. This is the highest point in Panama. We get to see the city when we get to the top. I'm here with my boy Carlos. Came for the journey. We about to go up, I think it's like 2 miles to get to the top. We about to start our journey up these steps. Up Ancon Hill. Let's do it. Got some more steps. Buenas. Hey little man, what's up little man? Come on Carlos, man. Nice. Move a little slow, bro. Move a little slow. Most steps. Most steps. Alright, looks like we have to go up some more roads. A lot of people walking back down. Buenas. Protect the animals. Whoa! Look at the view! Still got a long way to go. Finally making it to the top. Let's see right here. Alright, finally made it to the top. Show you the view. Panama. Whoa. Beautiful view. Top of Ancon Hill. I think that's where the Panama Canal is at. Right there in front of us. Ancon Hill with my man Los. Doing it. It was about a good mile. A little mile run up there. Got a good view. Started raining a little bit. We good. We just walking down. We walking down the hill. Alright, about to cross the street real quick to take a cab to Albrook Mall. About to get some cabs over here. They just chilling. They chilling over there. States. got dropped off at Albrook Mall. It's one of the largest malls in Panama City. Just about to go and get some AC, check out some clothes, maybe get some food. Got some ice cream. Claro. It is the cell phone service here in Panama. Just walking around the mall. Albrook Mall. Movie star. So we're at the Panama Albrook Mall. Checking out the food court. A lot of Spanish flavor. They pretty much got everything here. Wendy's, Taco Bell, Dunkin' Donuts. Everything here. Stop by one of these clothing stores in the mall. Try to buy some cheap clothes. Cause it's hot as a bitch out here. Alright, so I got my man Los in the back. We just ordered the Uber. Our first Uber in Panama.
Cheap too.
Got my driver Carlos. We just got dropped off in La Central, Panama. It's a really cheap shopping area. It's outside. A place where you can bargain. La Central. Oh, they got some ice cream here. It's really cheap too. In the central area. Guy digging through trash. Trying to look for some gold. He's looking for some gold. So it's got a fresh coconut water for $1, bro. $1, so good. Just walked to the end of La Sentada. These trees look pretty cool. All right, so we made our way out towards the coast. Just walking around, enjoying the views of Panama. My home country. Alright guys, about to do a little stroll in Panama City. Cold-blooded. Who do you? Girl, who do you belong to? My point of view is, girl, I think you're hot. What words could I describe? There's no dictionary book to explain how you look. Girl, I think you suck. Cold-blooded. What more can I say? Walking around aboard Los. Enjoying the view of Panama.
Passion fruit, pineapple, and lemon.
Panama does it.
Passion fruit, it's good. $1. It's $1. Then they put malt. I don't like it with malt.
Okay.
But then they put condensed milk. See?
There
you go. Alright, we're on a little sidewalk area.
walking off the coast of Panama City.
View.
Panama, downtown. Looks like New York City. About to cross this little bridge. Alright guys, Isaac checking in. We did some walking, sightseeing, and right now we're at my friend Martin's house. He's chilling in the backyard, I'm chilling on his hammock, just waiting for him to get home from work.
The guy tried to charge us $5 when the taxi was going to charge us $3.
No, the Uber was going to charge us $3.
Yeah, Uber is cheaper than taxis.
Yeah.
I don't get
Baghdad, bro.
This is Baghdad.
Look here.
Where? Yeah, you get fucking robbed here, nigga.
Oh my god. With the church. Cross.
Right next to the church, nigga.
Look at this. The hood. Alright, currently right now we're in Casco Viejo. About to pregame. Maybe take some shots and shit. I got my man Martin and my boy Carlos about to tear it up tonight. Alright, we're in the main area of Casco Viejo. Looks like it's about to be a party tonight. Man Los, my man Martin.
Straight legend over here, Martin.
Legend. Chillin'. My man. Look. What you got there, bro?
God damn.
Yeah,
that shit look good, bro. Right now it's about be 10 a.m. Saturday morning in Panama. My friend Martin is about to drop us off at the Panama Canal, and he's going to some cycling event, so he's going out of town, so it's gonna be me and Carlos. But yeah man, we're gonna go to the Panama Canal, take some pictures, and go from there. So in Colombia, when you order a sancocho, they usually give you a big ass bowl. I think that's a small, but in Panama, when you order a sancocho, they give you a little bitty bowl. Little itty bitty bowl. My man Los about to grill on this breakfast sandwich. Oh my god, bro. Look at that. Look at that shit. Oh my god. About to tear it up, bro. Alright, so we just got dropped off at the Miraflores, which is the visiting center for the Panama Canal. We're about to enter it. See it right here, Miraflores. About to go up this damn escalator. Holy shit! My man Los. Just so y'all know, if y'all want to come visit, here are the rules. Here's the hours of operation. Alright. Oh my god. Who is that? Alright, it's the entrance. It's got my ticket. It was $15. That's 5 times the price that Panamanian citizens pay to see the Panama Canal. Fun fact. Oh, they got a little coffee shop here too. Alright, so this is the Panama Canal Visiting Center. Viewing Center. Man Los on his phone. The Panama Canal.
Mia Flores. See this? This is where they raise and lower the water level so the ships can pass. Got a little viewing seat from here. We're about to try out some of these exhibitions. Get a little history, the cultural awareness. Got a little ticket right here. About to scan that bitch. All right, what they got in here? 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 Videos too. Oh. Exhibit 2. Exhibit 2? Oh man, the escalator doesn't work. Oh no. Some bug. Exhibit number 2. So I guess this little machine here tells you your water weight. I guess. We'll try it out. Oh! What am I gonna be? Damn! Oh my god! 64%. Alright, so we're at exhibit 3 right now. Just went at the escalator. Oh! Look at this, look at this, look at this. Exhibit 4. Exhibit 4. The very top. See some stuff here. So I guess that was all the exhibits that we did for the Panama Canal. We're about to head back, go to Panama Viejo. It's close to where my grandparents stay. Alright, I just arrived to my grandfather's house. He's been living here for I think 40, 50 years, but this is where we're staying at for tonight. So I'll give you a little tour where. Oops. I just walked upstairs. This is my grandfather's crib. It's one of the rooms. You have the living room right here. Got the kitchen. Out here is a balcony. You can go out. This is the area. It's called Parque La Febre. The neighborhood my grandfather lives in. I'll show you some of the other rooms. The kitchen. Where we do laundry. My man Los. Got one of the bathrooms right here. Another bedroom. Another bedroom. And another one. Little private bathroom tour here too. Mm-hmm. All right, I just got dropped off to Panama Viejo. My aunt and my grandfather dropped me off. See, they're leaving right there. Their little car. All right, we're in Panama Viejo. It's about 5 minute walk from where my grandfather lives. So I actually been here before. I like went running one day and happened to stumble upon these ruins. All right, this is Panama Viejo. We just found out we had to pay $15 to see some ruins that, I don't know, man. $15? That's how much you pay to see the Panama Canal. Now we're here, just walking around destroyed buildings. All right, walking through the ruins. Here we are. Panama Viejo.
Holy shit.
Look at this. I'm walking around Panama Viejo.
Get up there and take a picture.
Where?
On the rock.
Maybe I should. Looking at the ruins here, doesn't look like too much is going on. Just a bunch of tore down buildings from a long time ago. The main tower in Panama Viejo. About to go up this mug, get a good shot, get a good view. Going up these stairs. Looks like somebody having a little party wedding going on.
You got some water?
Or see right here. This is the top of the tower, beach area. I'm on here. Right here too. I took a good. And for the left, city. Here, behind there, there's a bunch of ruins over there. Hey! Hey! Okay, okay. And look at that big ass pile. They, damn, that's a big ass leaf pile. While I film. Right here, my city. Alright, so we just went up that big ass building right behind us. Got some good views. What you think of that, Carlos?
Really refreshing.
Refreshing?
Yeah.
Was it worth the $15?
No.
Definitely not worth the $15, but, you know.
It is what it is.
You only live once. You live and you learn. You live and you learn. Alright. Me and my boy Los, we just left Panama Viejo. We're walking back to my grandfather's apartment since it's walking distance.
Yeah,
and then... Then we're going to Casco Viejo tonight to look for girls and
single
hang out. Single men. Let's do it. Man, oh my guy right here. All right, so we just got dropped off at Casco Viejo. We're gonna spend our night here. with the festivities. Me and my man Los, ready to party it up. Just showing you where we at. About to tear it up. Let's go. This is what the area looks like during the evening time. That's where I strolled earlier the other day. Remember walking through here at nighttime last night? Alright, so we about to pass through these two spots we went to last night. Look at the city.
Yo sí soy un soprano, hermano, tú sabes que yo te gano temprano. Mira, improvisando, no me levanten la mano. No trae abrigo, compa, si estamos en verano.
No traes abrigo, sí, tengo en verano. Pero que tiene que ver la ropa, si igual, compa, yo te gano. Me siento un idiota, te pongo a hacer un amor. No importa tanto la ropa, que te pego a quemar ropa.
Mira, yo sí soy un lírico.
My man Los, so what did the lady say to you about this club right here?
Open bar until 3 o'clock.
Open.
They open at 10, open bar until 3.
3, 8, so that's 5 hours of drinking for $20.
$20, my nigga, is the cover.
What is it called? Teatro Amador. We going there tonight. It's about 7 o'clock. We're walking around Casco Viejo. Just checking out the spots before we go out tonight. About to go in Pio Pio real quick. Get some chicken or something. Some sancocho or something. Hungry. Alright, I'm still in Casco Viejo, killing some time until the club opens, walking around, enjoying the views. I guess the club we're going to is a Red Bull party, so we got some free Red Bulls from those Red Bull girls that you see in America. See the Red Bull car right here? It's the club we're going to right here. Night. Open bar, $20 all night.
You got three.
Alright, so we're in line right now. Look like it's all girls in line. Okay. Oh, well.
Panama PTY 507 la libra. fucking DJ lost, trying to figure out what the fuck he's doing. Come on, DJ. You got this, DJ. Come on. Turn that shit back on, man. Club, what'd you think, Carlos?
Awesome.
Yo, that was a dope ass fucking club, man. Now we about to go somewhere else. We just left the club. You're going. My man Los. Relax. Ain't no car gonna hit us tonight. Yo, we'll be going. We about to go to the spot.
Yeah, malaria, you bitches.
Going back to the crib.
Alright, so we decided to go to the Multiplaza Mall in Panama. It's probably the biggest mall here. It's kind of like the International Mall in Tampa. So we're just entering right now. About to buy my little cousin a gift, and then from there we're gonna meet up with my aunt. So this Multiplaza Mall has all the stores in America. American Eagle, Express, everything is here, man. Oh my god. What the hell is this? Bumper cars. I'm also looking for a gift for my little cousin. She's only a year and a half. We're in the Fisher Price store. They have a Fisher Price store in this mall. So I got my little cousin some gifts. Got the little girl some Fisher Price toy. Got my cousin, the guy, a Lego creator, and a Dragon Ball Z Nintendo Switch game. Ta-da. Alright, so my family took me to a seafood, Panamanian seafood restaurant off the coast. I'm here with my grandpa, my cousin, my aunt, and my friend. We called natto fish and chorizo, Panamanian seafood. This is the view. So this is the view from my aunt's apartment building. She lives in like one of these similar looking buildings, and we're on the 7th floor. It's called Bellevue Towers. Nice area. Yo, so what's up? We decided to go to Trump Tower in Panama because we hate him so much. We just wanted to see what his building looked like. But we also heard on the 66th floor, there's a really good view of the city. So we're just gonna check that out. And yeah, man, probably piss on the side of the building afterwards.
That's nice.
I got some big feet. Holy shit. Damn. It says big. Oh, it's Bigfoot. Damn, that's a big feet. The Trump Tower. It's actually a nice building. It sticks out between all the other buildings. Alright, we just got dropped off at the Trump Tower. We were trying to go to the Panama Viejo, which is on the 66th floor. It gives you a very good view of the city. But we were just told that they open at 6:30 for the sunset view. So we got here an hour early, so we're probably just going to go somewhere and come back. So we're in the part of Panama City where all those tall buildings are at. Everywhere we go. Oh my gosh. Never seen this before. All this shit too. Excuse me. We got another good view of the city. We're about to see the Panama sign right there. Infamous Panama sign. Gracefully take a photo. Hopefully block our view. Kids taking some photos. I get a photo up with nobody, and the people have no manners. I'm sitting here for almost 10 minutes trying to get a photo. Everybody just keep coming up and taking photos of just one letter. Like, what's the whole point of just taking that photo? Look at this guy, look at this guy. Damn, boy! Keep going.
This nigga has reverse. Oh. No, I'm done.
Come back. So we were on our way to Trump Tower in our Uber, and our Uber driver, which he was a local, he's done like 5,000 trips, so he knows the area pretty well, and he was telling me that the Hard Rock Cafe had a better view of the city, so we just said, fuck Trump, and we're just gonna go to Hard Rock Cafe and get the view from there, because, you know, we hate Trump, so. But yeah, I'm about to go up this elevator right now. And after that, we're gonna go to Panamanian Hooters. Woo! Then my ears pop. Alright, so we're going to the 62nd floor, which is the very top. You're currently on the 45th, about to be in 50.
Fuck Trump.
The Trump Tower has 66 floors, so, I mean, the 4-floor difference shouldn't make a big deal. Plus, the Uber driver said it had a way better view of the city because it's in a centralized location. So, yeah! We about to see it. Open sesame. This place is called Bits. It's a bar.
Top floor. There's nobody here.
Whoa, this is nice.
Man, this is a lot better.
Boy, the fuck. So this is the view from the 62nd floor of the Hard Rock, which you can see up here. And there's like a little bar around here you can go to. Get a drink. There's a couple of couches you can chill. Bring a girl. Shall I bring... Bar right behind us to get some drinks or something. Chill. Alright, guys, I'm gonna show you a quick panoramic view of the city. Goes all the way around. All around. Me and my nigga Los chilling. Hard Rock Cafe, the top floor, the bar, drinking some Balboas.
High life,
bro. Talk about. We're walking at nighttime in Panama City. About to check out Hooters right now. It's a little dark out here. It's all good. Alright, we just made it to the Hooters. About to watch the Royal Rumble. It's free. We're playing the Royal Rumble. About to sit down and get some wings. See the Panamanian girl. Yo, Panamanians going crazy over Royal Rumble, man. They're all fans here. They're all fans here, bro. Yo, it's funny, when John Cena comes out, everybody boos for him. In Panama, they don't like him. They love Rey Mysterio in Panama. So we're in the Hooters in Panama. And we've been there for about 45 minutes and still haven't took our order. The Royal Rumble was almost done. And we haven't took our order yet. We don't know what's going on. Service sucks here. So we just left the Hooters in Panama. Didn't get served one time. Horrible experience. Not coming back here. We watched the whole Royal Rumble. The waitress has passed us like at least 10 times. Never like the fucking manager asked us, have we been served after like maybe 45 minutes? And we were like, nah, like we're trying to order. She gives us the menu and then she leaves. And, you know, just never bothered to follow up with us. She passed us probably about 2 or 3 times. It wasn't even really that busy inside, you know? And that just proves how bad the service in Panama is, right? What do you think, Carlos, about Hooters?
Terrible. Never ever again.
Why is that?
Service sucks and the women weren't even that good looking.
Yeah, man. So don't go to Hooters anymore, man. Stay that shit in America. Keep that shit in America. Still pissed off at that Hooters, man. But sometimes
you live and you learn
and there's always a reason why things happen.
Turn left onto Avenida 5AB, sir.
God damn it, my GPS. But you know, because before we went to Hooters, there was this other place that's kind of like Hooters, but it's the Panamanian version of it. And they were like trying to get us to go in. They were like very sexy looking girls. And they were, you know, trying to like offer us free shots. And we didn't even make it inside the door. They were like waiting for us when we got up the stairs, right? And then we wanted to get that Hooters experience, you know, like that Panamanian Hooters experience, because we can't get that in the U.S., you know? So that ended up being a fail, and now we're gonna actually get the real Panamanian experience from a Panamanian owned restaurant. So we'll check it out. All right, so this is our last 3-4 hours in Panama. Right now it's about 9 p.m. No, it's 10 p.m. 10 p.m. And we just decided to go back to Casco Viejo one more time. Our flight leaves at 3 a.m. Holy
shit.
So we're pretty much just gonna get shit-faced until 1 a.m. and then make our way back home to pick up our bags and then go straight to the airport. So yeah, we about to turn up tonight for our last couple hours of a vacation. This place is called Lazoteca. It's in Casco Viejo. It's a rooftop restaurant and bar. They have a swimming pool. They have a nice little view. They got little chairs y'all can. They have a view of Casco Viejo and the water, and the city in the backlight. Everybody here just chilling on a Sunday, trying to drink all the beers.
Right.
We just got to the airport. We had a little issue with our Uber driver. She was like super late, and then she had a flat tire when she picked us up. And I gave her a chance. She was like, oh, I can just put some air in it. I'll go to a gas station down the street, and we'll be good to go. And then I was like, all right, cool. Then we go to the gas station and she ends up having a hole in her tire. And I'm like, all right, now we definitely gotta like you know, find another Uber because we're gonna be late. And she was like, no, just give me a second. I can change my spare tire. And we were like, all right, cool. We'll just hurry up. So I gave her another chance. And then she didn't know how to use the jack. So I waited for like 5 more minutes. And I was like, nah, we gotta go. And then Carlos ordered the Uber. He came within 5 minutes. And we were here just in time before the gate closed. So if we would have stuck with that lady, we would have been stuck. About to board a plane. Los, what you think about Panama, man?
Want to go to bed. Tired
too. 3 a.m. man. 3 a.m. Got work in the morning. So trip is pretty much done. So tired, man. Got work in like 5-6 hours. So we figure out gotta tough it out at work. But yep. Hope y'all liked the video. Oh, it's in the back. Me and my boy Lof in the very back.
Back
row 31. You don't even have a window, bro.
That's how they feel about us.
You don't even have a window. Man, Lof's looking comfy. About to get a speedy rest.
There's no window.
Overall, Panama was a very good time. Good to see family and sightsee and get to explore the city where I was born. Definitely gonna come back and see more family. Get to know the younger generation of my family. I can't wait to go back and make this video to show you guys because it took a lot of video. I really hope that you guys can understand why I do my traveling and understand that I'm doing this because I love it. It's my passion. So my next trip is going to be in a couple weeks. I'm going to Colombia and I'm just mentally prepared for that because I'm going to be there for 5 days. It's going to be dope. Alright guys, I'm about to get some sleep. It's 3 o'clock in the morning and I gotta go work pretty much when I get back because we're gonna get back at 10 and I'm just going straight to work from the airport, so gotta make that money. Peace.